In this tutorial, we'll be looking at buoyancy effector 2D. So let's look at it with an example. In this example, there are two main components. The first is the box. This box has a rigid body 2D and a box slider 2D attached to it. Now, I have kept the mass of this box to 0.1. I have kept its body type to dynamic. And I have this water sprite. I have attached to it a box slider 2D. To this component, I'll add buoyancy effector 2D. So as soon as you add it, you'll get a warning message that it won't function unless you tick this use by effector. So I just need to tick this use by effector. Then you get another warning that the ease trigger is unchecked. So I need to just check this ease trigger. Let's run it with its default values. So there it goes. The box just went through this water. If you look at it carefully, it slows down a little bit when it comes into interaction with the water. So if I need to stop this box from going below this water, I need to increase this density. Density is at present 2, I'll increase it to 15. So density is the amount of density that this water holds within it. Let's run it again. Here you see that the box comes down and it sticks to the water. Now we look at the collider mask and collider in the end. So the first was the density property. The next is the surface level. Now, where do you want this buoyancy force to be applied? That point is called the surface level. At present, it's at 0. It's in the center of our water sprite. I'm not sure if you can see it. I'll zoom it a little bit. I'll just turn off the sprite. Here you can see a green line. Now, this is the surface level. So this is the point where you have the force applied onto this box. Now, if I want this force to be applied somewhere on the surface, I can increase this value. Now the force will be applied at this point. If I run this game, you'll see that now the buoyancy force is applied close to the top or the surface of this water. The next property we discuss is the damping. We have two properties, linear drag and angular drag. So linear drag is the amount of drag that this box experiences when it interacts with water. So at present it's 5. If I run it, you'll see that the box kind of bounces off once it gets to the water. If I want to stop this bounce, I can increase this linear drag value to say somewhere around 20. Let's run it again. So here now you see that this box does not bounce as much as it used to bounce before. The next property is the angular drag. The angular drag is the amount of drag that the box experiences if it is having a rotation. That is, if you need to slow down the rotation of any game object, you just need to increase this angular drag value. Let's keep it to 5. The next property we discuss is the flow. Inside the flow, we have three properties: flow angle, flow magnitude, and flow variation. Flow angle is the direction of the flow. If you want to give a direction to the flow of this water, then you can use this flow angle. To the right is 0 degrees, to the top is 90, to the left is 180, and below is 270. So what I can do is, I'll make this flow angle to say around 180. I want to move it to the left. Now in order to make this work, I'll have to give a value in this magnitude. That is the flow magnitude. That is the amount of speed that water has towards that direction. So I'll give it to say around 20. Let's check it. So here you see that once it collides with this water, or the box collides with water, it goes to the left side. So that is flow magnitude. And the last property in it is the flow variation. Now the flow variation is the variation in the flow magnitude. So if I give here a value, suppose 10, then the box will experience a flow magnitude ranging from 20 to 30. I'll run it again. So now the box experiences a magnitude or a flow magnitude of somewhere around 20 to 30. The final property for this buoyancy effector is the collider mask. Now, if you keep this unchecked, then the global collision matrix will be used for collisions. But if you keep this ticked, then you have a little drop down here in the collider mask. Here you can select those layers with which you want the water to interact with. At present, it's interacting with everything. Suppose I don't want this water to interact with those objects whose layer is set to top one. So what I can do is, I can deselect this top one. I can see it again that now the top one is deselected. So in order to make you understand this, what I'll do is, I'll take this box, I'll change its layer to top one. So now if I run this, you'll see that the box goes right through this water. So the use collider mask is basically used in order to make the water interact with only those layers which you want them to interact with. So I hope you understood about the buoyancy effector 2D.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.